Lenovo has pushed past the traditional laptop market and introduced their latest tablet-laptop hybrid, the Yoga Book. Now, I'd already seen quite a few reviews of the Windows 10 version of this tablet, but those seemed to kinda miss the mark. The interesting part of this product, in my opinion, was the idea that this could also be a laptop tablet running Android. So here's my take on the Lenovo Yoga Book with the Android ecosystem. I'm EposVox, here to make tech easier and more fun via free educational videos, here today with a review of a pretty cool little product. The Lenovo Yoga Book is a 10.1-inch 2-in-1 tablet-laptop combo with Lenovo's fantastic watchband hinge. This is the same style of hinge that was on the Lenovo Yoga 900 laptop that I reviewed last year. It keeps the screen from bouncing too much or adjusting the angle on its own, but it's easy to open and shut. And it just looks cool. The screen is a very nice looking 1920 by 1200 IPS display. Pretty damn good for a tablet or a laptop. For a fully spec'd out unit, inside is an Intel Atom X5 Z8550 processor, up to 4GB of LPDDR3 RAM, and up to 64GB of internal storage. Dolby Atmos speakers are also present, along with an 8500mAh battery. In my month or so of use, I've only had to charge it twice and I rarely had it powered down. I'm impressed. Opposing the screen is their new Halo keyboard. No, not that kind of Halo. This is a capacitive touch keyboard where there are no physical keys, just a large solid surface with backlighting to outline where keys would be. I wrote a couple of video scripts on this. It was a very different experience that took some getting used to. But by like half an hour in, I was typing pretty fast and comfortably. That was until the Google Docs app randomly stopped accepting letter inputs or the keyboard would randomly switch to French. More on that in a minute. I certainly wouldn't use this as a daily driver for typing and writing, but for quick notes in a classroom or just casually responding to quick emails and social media posts, this is totally viable. The keyboard also houses an emulated trackpad, which works fairly well, though it is quite small. And if capacitive typing isn't your thing, you can also handwrite with this. By holding down the pencil button at the top of the keyboard and using the included stylus pen, you can use real ink to write on real paper while having it save in the Notes app digitally as well. I was very, very impressed with how natural this felt and with the quality of the results from doing so, especially the digital versions just look really, really good, but I'm still writing on physical paper. Writing was detected through even the thick notepad that Lenovo provides, but you do have to use their pen, which I found to be uncomfortable to use. A trade-off, I guess. I'm excited to see where this technology goes in the future. Finishing off the physical build of the Yoga Book, it comes in champagne gold, gunmetal gray, and carbon black colors, and looks and feels very similar to the Yoga 900. A nice cool metal feeling and completely sturdy, no flex whatsoever. Given that the folding aspect doesn't allow for any rubber feet or gripping on the bottom, however, it can slip quite easily on just about any surface, and scratching would be an issue to its look. On one side, you get a micro USB port, which you'd use to charge the tablet, a micro SD slot, which can be loaded up to 128GB, and it's in the iPhone SIM tray slot style. Not sure I'm a fan. There's also a micro HDMI output, which can go up to 4K 30Hz, and a speaker grille. Microphones line the front bezel edge. The other side features a speaker grille, headphone combo jack, volume rocker, and lock and power button. The 2 megapixel 1080p front camera is located on the bezel above the screen, and the 8 megapixel 1080p rear camera is located on the keyboard. So when it's folded up like a tablet, it's actually on the rear. Here's a couple samples.
This is a video in selfie mode test with the Lenovo Yoga Book in my normal studio lighting setup. So what you normally see for the A-roll take of this video. And this is what it looks like in a standard room with basic CFL lighting, as if I was having a late night Skype call or something. Obviously this is an unflattering angle down here on my lap, but up a bit more, it's not too bad. The color's a little bit weird and it's quite noisy, but it's passable for a Skype camera. Now this is the rear camera. Again, still fairly noisy under normal conditions, but with studio lighting, everything is just way too overexposed. So, looks like that's just the general limitation of the camera. It also has a huge crop factor. Touch to focus there. We don't really get much touch to focus action. Just a basic camera.
This brings us to the software. What is using this device actually like? Lenovo brags about their custom Android ROM, capable of windowed Android apps and better productivity, and I'm hyped for future iterations of this idea, but I'm not a huge fan at the moment. The typical bottom bar on Android has been modified to act as a taskbar of sorts, with the back, home, task switcher, and app drawer buttons hugging the left, then open window indicators for the rest. On the far right is a button to switch to the real pin writing mode. This is alright and a good bridge between the expected Android and desktop experiences. The clock and notifications still occupy a small panel at the top and integrates quite well. I'm satisfied with this. The home screen is fluid and responsive, and easy enough to navigate. What Lenovo has done to desktopify the Android operating system on the whole is fine. The problem lies in using traditional Android apps. Lenovo's File Manager, Google Chrome, Google Docs, and so on all work wonderfully on this device. Maximized or in windowed mode, I feel like I'm on a normal laptop using these apps. It was a welcome surprise. Other apps from the Play Store, however, not so much. With most apps, games, Snapchat, Instagram, etc., you have the choice of a pretty tiny vertical windowed mode or full screen mode. This wouldn't be a problem, of course, except most of the apps that I've tried only do full screen mode in the vertical orientation. To make matters worse, they don't scale properly. The 16:10 aspect ratio of the screen means that when it's displayed vertically, many apps stretch out to fill the width of the screen and wind up looking super distorted. And you're just stuck with that. So whenever I'm using the Yoga Book in laptop mode and Instagram opens maximized, the entire experience turns sideways until I switch to something else, or unmaximize it. This isn't a problem for all apps. Google Apps, YouTube, Facebook, and Facebook Messenger do just fine staying in the landscape orientation when maximized. But the elements are scaled so largely that it's still not easy to use. I would still prefer it in the vertical windowed mode, which is super tiny on the screen. Android as a desktop operating system just isn't there yet. Again, I'm stoked to see where this idea takes us, and I will be closely following this project, along with Remix OS, another take on the Android for PC idea, and Google's Fuchsia OS, which is rumored to be a combination of their Android and Chrome operating systems for a more unified environment moving forward, but we'll see where those go. And overall, the custom ROM just felt like it really lacked polish. HDMI output seems to be finicky about whether it wanted to work with my capture device, not a problem I've had with other devices, and customizing certain settings just felt off. Not to mention the serious keyboard problems I had while writing scripts. They were hard to capture since they were completely random as far as I could tell, but while typing in Google Docs, sometimes it would just stop accepting letter inputs. I could delete text, type numbers, and so on, but it just would not accept letters. Other times, the keyboard kept randomly switching to French. After about the second time that happened, I went in and manually disabled all other languages myself, and it still somehow managed to re-enable the French keyboard and stop screwing with any word being accepted. Both of these issues seem to be tied to the autofill and autocorrect tools built into their Android keyboard. That's the only way I can really figure out how to explain it. It was incredibly frustrating when the keyboard kept freaking out like 5 times during one video script, however, and it made me quickly want to stop using it. This is a really, really neat product concept. I've loved hybrid laptops for as long as they've been a thing, and I will keep an eye on future iterations of these ideas for years to come. But this is not a device that I would use as my daily driver for anything but a super lightweight, casual travel device. If I'm someone who regularly moves between an office and a home office, only needing something basic to engage on social media and email at the occasional coffee shop stop or something, absolutely. But to replace my laptop with this, not so much. Then again, the Windows 10 version seems to be a bit more polished. I'll include some links to reviews of that Yoga Book in the description below. I hope you enjoyed this review. If you did, smash the like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos, and I will see you next time.